Hello, and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox on the Series X. And I'm hoping this audio is actually okay. If it isn't, I'm afraid I'm not sure if we'll have a video up this week or not. I'll potentially ask a question in the community. Tab, would you rather have a video with subtitles and slightly scratchy audio until this audio issue with Twitch is fixed, or no video at all and a clear audio video? But yeah, here we are on the main menu of Space Engineers, and a big welcome to the PlayStation users for the beta of Space Engineers. With the release of the game coming, I've noticed a few people from the PlayStation have found my channel and have found my content. Thank you very much. I really do appreciate the support from the PlayStation community. As you No, the game is essentially the same. The controls will be slightly different, but I'm sure you can remap them in your brain with my Xbox controls, RB being R1 and so on. Why am I on the main menu? Well, you may have noticed a slight quality of life change when it comes to loading up a game in Space Engineers recently. And if I click on this world here, you may notice there is a loading percentage underneath the loading icon itself. Now, this isn't always 100% accurate, but it gives you a better idea of what's going on in the background. That's just get rid of this. So, if the audio is working properly, I'll be happy. I won't be able to test it because, unfortunately, if I try to test it, it can cause feedback and so on. So I'm going to proceed as though you can hear me properly. And if you can't, I apologize that I sound like the comedian Norman Collier. And if you don't know who that is, look that up and you'll see why. I'm not going to demonstrate because you might think there are audio issues on the channel, which there may be. I do not know. But to get right into this, we're going to look today at the AI flight move block in combination with the AI basic task block to create a follow drone. Now, we need to build one at first. And the best way to do this is for me to show you how I approach building anything in Space Engineers. So, what I need, first of all, actually, is some batteries. Normally, you'd have like a base with either a reactor or some wind turbines or some solar power. But here we have some batteries and a platform. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to slap down a, there it is, a basic router. And then I'm just going to pop open the build menu with the left stick, clicked in, go to the button panel, push up on the D-pad until I've got what I want, which is this little blue panel here, the control panel. And pressing down on the D-pad changes the axis of rotation. So we want to rotate it around the blue axis until the keypad is at the bottom and the circle is at the top. Then what we want to do here, just for now, in the control panel, is go to the rotor. Just turn on rotor lock. Now we've done that. In survival mode, you'll be grinding the head off like this. And then you want to add a small head. Now we can build small grid off a large grid. It's a hybrid building style. People have been using it for ages. And essentially, this rotor here allows power to transfer from our grid through to the grid we're building, because if Space Engineers detects an unpowered grid, it's going to delete it, especially if you're playing on a server. There, some servers have extremely draconic trash cleanup, as they call it. So we're going to start with a little gantry here, and we're going to build just a few blocks up. And the first thing we want is a cargo box. A small cargo container, as you can see. Push up on the D-pad, we get the other cargo container. So that's our box. Because what we're going to do is we're going to make a little flying box drone that will follow us at around 5 meters away and stay about 2 to 5 meters off the ground and allow us to kind of ferry stone and other things back to our base to save our inventory. Now, what we want here is we're going to need a power source. So let's just pop a couple of batteries down. You can put more batteries in if you want, and because I'm in creative mode, you'll see that I am building batteries and they're going straight up to full storage straight away. So there is our beginnings of our drone. And every drone needs a few things, or every ship, vehicle, and space engineers. For a start, we're going to need a way for the AI to control the turning of this. We stick a gyroscope on, and if we cut the block off now, it's going to drop because we don't have any thrusters. Let's give it some thrust. We're going to give it four thrusters on the thrust. We're going to give it couple of thrusters for forward and backward. And it's going to need some down thrust. And the most important thing is when you're dealing with AI, anything remote control blocks, you name it, you need thrust in every direction. So the last thrust we want is left and right. So now we have, again, the basis of our drone. Still not going to do anything though, because it lacks the AI brain. In this case, we hold down both bumpers, tap X, we can quick save. So if we cut the blocks and our thrusters aren't working properly or something bad happens, we're not going to be stuffed. Here we go. What do we need now? Well, since this is a very basic and simple drone, we're going to require just two things. We're going to require an AI flight move block, and you can see there is no way to put these blocks on incorrectly. Well, there is, but if you ensure that the rear panel is facing that way and the F is there, then everything else is correct on the left and the right. We're also going to require an AI basic task. Now, this doesn't have to be placed in any specific place on the ship. Also, it doesn't have to be placed in any specific way, although I do like to rotate mine so the little flag on the planet is like that. Here we have our basis of our drone. Just a little bit setup required for it to work. Into our control panel. We can access that through our cargo box. Pop our control panel open and then just use our D-pad and go up to the top to the first one, AI basic task. It's already set to follow the player. We want it to follow at about 5 meters. So hold the right bumper down and tap in on the left of the D-pad with RB held down. And you will be able to change the follow distance in increments by 2 meters at a time. Or you can type it in by pressing A and pressing A again and just typing the value in. Moving on, AI flight move. Now, we want to turn collision avoidance off, otherwise our AI is going to get confused around grids and voxels and things at the moment for this demonstration. If you do turn it on, expect it to behave strangely when it comes to the ground because it won't like to get too low, even if you tell it that it's safe. Distance, minimum altitude is 2 meters. It will not be too happy. So we set that to 2 meters, leave its speed at 10, leave a line peak gravity on, change this to zero, change this to zero. And how I did that was hold down both bumpers and then press left or right on the D-pad, and you will basically go between far right, middle, and far left on the slider. There we are. That is all we need, apart from to obviously turn on the AI behavior on this and turn on the AI behavior on this. Still not done though. Almost, but not quite. We still need to tell this to be able to follow us and stop following us. One way of doing it is bringing up our button panels, selecting our button there, press X on that one, choose the AI basic task block and tell it follow me. You'll see that the grey switch now lights up to let you know that the button is active and has a setting on it. Same deal with that one. Set that one. Stop following. Bit of a quick save and we are ready to test our little boxy drone. Cutting free. Hovering nicely. Cut that like that. And then what we need to do is press follow me. And then we'll go over here. Turn the jetpack off with Y. And you can see our little cargo box drone is following me around as I go about my daily space engineers. Tootle over here, like so. And our drone is still following us. And then if we say it's some drilling, a bit of stone, like so. And if you want to automatically pick up stone in the area, hold down X and you can do it while drilling, so you don't have to worry about picking it up afterwards. You can just keep it held down, and now we can just come underneath, find that stone, pop it in, and then off we go. Back to base, and our little drone is following us as we go. Back to base. We can either unload this manually, stop following me, and our drone is quite happy to stay there. That's the basic setup on something like that. You can make it a little more fun if you so desire, by adding, especially if you have the DLC, if you go to your symbols section, you can choose the emotion controller. Pop an emotion controller down, make sure the arrows are facing up and the control panel is on the side with the circle facing up. Then just choose an emotion for the emotion controller to begin with. We want our emotion controller to be sad. Sad drone. Now, next thing. Again, if you have the DLC side of this, you could choose the sensor for the automaton sensor and look at the arrows here. Place that down, interact with it in the front panel with X, and choose set of actions. Then pick our emotion controller. And when we enter, oops, wrong one. There we go. When we enter the field, we want it to be, let's go for happy. And when we exit the field, we'll make it sad again. So when we're in the center field, it's happy to see us. And when we move out, it's sad. So when it's following us, when it gets close enough, it's happy again. And there you go. That is how to make a little cargo drone that follows you around obediently, picks up the cargo. But what you could do is you could also put an AI recorder task block on there and go a little more advanced and have it so that if you pressed a third button, it would automatically scoot back to your base, drop off whatever cargo is in there into a hopper, and then come back. But to do that, you'd need two task recorders. And I could look at doing another video on that. That's a little more advanced setup for this particular style of drone. I just wanted to demonstrate the simple drone as compared to the other. I'm hoping the audio has behaved itself. I have a horrible feeling it probably hasn't, because there are some serious issues at the moment with the Xbox integration of Twitch that's plaguing not just me, but a whole bunch of other streamers. Recently, I've seen lots of complaints online about it. We can but continue to do what we do and wait and see if Xbox and Twitch fixes this. Hopefully, there is a fix soon. Until then, though, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. Loads more coming from Space Engineers, from me, and from Keen Software itself. Until then, though, bye for now.